Yeah, very good morning to one and all. In last class, we seen some of the digital to analog converters. Basically, a digital to analog converter is nothing but it is a circuit which converts the available digital signal. Digital signal means always which consisting of the codes of zeros and ones. So, which converts the digital signals into the analog signals. And the types of digital to analog converters are, first thing is weighted resistor digital to analog converter. Second thing is R2R ladder circuit digital to analog converter. And third thing is inverted R2R ladder digital to analog circuit. In last class, we completed the first two types of digital to analog converters. Those are weighted resistor digital to analog converter and R2R ladder circuit digital to analog converter. The circuit diagram of weighted resistor digital to analog circuit is like this, which consisting of some n number of resistances. The n number is depending upon length of the digital code, okay, which may be 4 bit, 8 bit, 3 bit, 6 bit, 7 bit, whatever it may be. The length of code and decides the number of resistors in the circuit. But the difficulty in the circuit is here the magnitude of resistance is depending upon the bit position. Okay, if it is a maximum bit is a third bit, we can use three number of resistors. If the maximum bit is four, you can use four number of resistances. And the magnitude of the resistance is also depending upon 2 power n into r. So we can use a huge value of resistance here. So in order to resolve this difficulty in the circuit of using high magnitudes of resistances in weighted resistor digital to analog converter, we go with the concept of R2R ladder circuit digital to analog converter. So in the concept of R2R ladder circuit digital to analog converter, we use only two magnitudes of resistance. One is R value and another one is 2R value. Only we can use two magnitudes of resistances. Those values are R and 2R. Generally, the value of R and 2R is varying from 2.5 kilo ohm to 10 kilo ohm only. Okay. And the number of resistors are also using here is also depending upon length of the string or length of the digital code. Okay. So we already calculated the formulas for output voltage. The output voltage is analog form and the magnitude of output voltage waveform is depending upon whatever the input digital data we are supplying. Okay. So depending upon the values in the input data, which is maybe 1 or 0, the switches can be connected with this corresponding resistance values in the ladder circuit. Okay. So this is about the R2R ladder circuit digital to analog converter. And the next thing is inverted R2R ladder circuit digital to analog converter. Okay, so the inverted R2R ladder digital to analog converter is shown in this figure, which consisting of a non-inverting operational amplifier, but the changes in inverted R2R ladder digital to analog converter and R2R ladder digital to analog converter is here the resistances. The ladder circuit resistances can be connected to both inverting and non-inverting terminals. In the concept of R2R ladder digital to analog converter, whether it may be connected to the resistance, ladder resistance values 2Rs can be connected to either reference voltage or ground voltage to the only inverting terminal of the operational amplifier. Okay, but here the reference voltage is always be connected with the ladder circuit of resistances. Okay, the input voltage, reference voltage value magnitude is fixed thing here, that is only negative VR. But in R2 or ladder circuit, the input voltage is either negative VR or zero, which can be decided by the magnitude of input. Okay, means digit of the input. If it is one, it is connected to negative VR. If it is zero, which is connected to the ground. Here it may be one or zero, whether whatever the input we have, it is always connected to the reference voltage negative VR, but the position of resistance is maybe changing with the either inverting or non-inverting terminals. Here the switches are connected to inverting and non-inverting terminals. The switch is tapped from either inverting terminal or to the non-inverting terminal, which is depending upon the magnitude of the digit. If the magnitude of the corresponding digit is one, logic high, it is connected to the inverting terminal. If the input to data, bit data is zero, which is connected to the positive terminal. So if the bit data is one, in that condition, the reference voltage is connected to the reference voltage is connected to the inverting terminal of our operational amplifier with the corresponding ladder resistance 2R. If the input bit data is zero, then the reference voltage is connected to the non-inverting terminal with the corresponding ladder resistance 2R. So all the 2R resistances in the ladder circuit are connected to either inverting terminal or non-inverting terminal through the reference voltage negative VR. And if you observe, this is a pure inverting operational amplifier. The non-inverting terminal is grounded like this. So which means here the voltage at the positive terminal is zero. So the resistances are connected to negative VR to the zero potential, because of if the positive terminal potential, non-inverting terminal potential is zero, due to the concept of virtual earth concept, the potential at the negative terminal is also zero, because of both inverting and non-inverting terminals are maintained at the same potential due to the concept of virtual earth connection. Okay, so always the resistors are connected to the negative reference voltage to the zero potential, which is either non-inverting terminal or to the inverting terminal. Why we go with this connection? Okay, here the question is, already we have R2 or ladder digital to analog converter. Why we go with the concept of inverted R2 or ladder digital to analog converter? Because of in binary weighted resistors, digital to analog converters, and R2 or ladder digital to analog converters, whatever we discussed previous classes, whatever the two different types of digital to analog converters we discussed, those are weighted resistor, digital to analog converter, or R2 or ladder digital to analog converter. They are depending upon the input data, DI may be 0 or 1. So the current through the resistors changes. The currents through the weighted resistor digital to analog converter or R2 or ladder digital to analog converter is depending upon the bit position of input data. If it is one, then current will flows in that corresponding resistor. If the bit data is zero, there is no current flows. Okay, so the current value is changing upon the availability of input data. It causes higher power dissipation, which makes the op amp enters into the non-linear operation of region. Because of the current flowing in the resistances, corresponding resistances, different magnitudes of currents are flowing in the different resistances, which makes the non-linear operation of our operational amplifier. Okay, so this non-linear operation will cause severe problems. Okay, so in order to overcome this limitation of non-linear operation of our operational amplifier, we go with the concept of inverted R2 or ladder digital to analog converter circuit. Okay, Let us consider a 3-bit inverted or 2 or digital to analog converter for the binary word 100. We are taking the input data as 100 for a 3-bit inverted digital to analog converter. If you observe the positions of the bits, if you take any digital input which having LSB and MSB, least significant bit and most significant bit. Here the data we are giving to our inverted O2 or ladder circuit is reverse that of O2 or ladder circuit. That's why we call it as inverted O2 or ladder circuit. Here in O2 or ladder circuit, we are giving inputs like this. Okay, this is MSB and this is LSB. Okay, but here we are giving LSB here, MSB here. The mannerism of giving input to data is reversed here. First we supply the MSB bit and last we supply LSB bit. Okay, that's why it is called as inverted O2 or ladder digital to analog converter, because of here we are reversing the bit sequence of input data. Okay, that's why it is called as inverted O2 or ladder digital to analog converter. Here the MSB and LSB are interchanged as compared to O2 or ladder circuit. Okay, when a particular bit DI is equal to 1, then the resistors and short circuited the resistor ends should be connected to the inverting terminal of operational amplifier, and if particular bit position DI is equal to 0, then the resistor ends are connected to the non-inverting terminal of the operational amplifier. If the bit data is 1, then the resistor ends are connected to the inverting terminal. If the bit data, corresponding bit data is 0, then the resistor ends are connected to the non-inverting terminal of the operational amplifier. As non-inverting terminals is at ground potential, according to virtual ground concept, the inverting terminal is also at the ground potential. Here we grounded the non-inverting terminal. According to the virtual earth concept, the voltage at the positive terminal is equal to voltage at the negative terminal. So both positive and negative terminals are maintained at the zero potentials. Okay. Ground potential, that is independent upon the input data, whether DI is equal to 0 or DI is equal to 1. Always the ends of the resistors are connected to the ground potential. If it is connected to inverting terminal or non-inverting terminal, always the ladder resistors are connected in between the reference voltage to the ground potential only, so that the current through each resistor is always remains constant independenting upon the data. Okay, so always the resistors are connected in between negative reference voltage to the ground. That's why all the resistors will carry the almost all same magnitudes of current values. It is independent upon the input data what we have. Okay, that is the difference between O2R and inverted O2R ladder circuits. Okay, and also the currents has very important properly, that the current through each resistance divides equally. Whatever the current flowing through all the resistors, whether they may be connected to the inverting terminal or non-inverting terminal, all the resistors will carry equal magnitude values. Okay, this is because of the equivalent resistance of the particular node on left and right hand side. Okay, there should be same value of equivalent resistances in left hand and right hand sides. That's why they will carry almost all same magnitude of current. Must always be having the resistance of 2R. Current through feedback resistance is depending upon total current through all the resistors, and the current in the feedback resistance is the sum of the currents through all the resistors. So this is the concept of inverted O2 or ladder digital to analog converter. This is also convert whatever the data we have, digital data we have, into the analog signal, corresponding magnitude of analog signal. Always be The magnitude of output voltage is depending upon the input bits we are supplying to the input to terminals. Okay. And next concept is IC1408 digital to analog converter. Actually, this is the last concept in digital to analog converters. Okay. So let me see about the IC1408 digital to analog converter. It is called as a monolithic digital to analog converter. It consisting of R2 or ladder feedback resistors and SPDT switches. The IC1408 internally consisting of our R2 or ladder feedback resistors with some SPDT, single pole double throw switches. Okay, so generally the IC chip number is available here like MC1408. Okay, MC1408 is the chip number of IC1408. Okay, so this MC1408 IC is an 8-bit digital to analog with output as the current. So our IC1408 digital to analog converter is a 8-bit digital to analog converter, and it will produces the output as the current signal. Okay, so we can this IC1408 chip will convert the digital input, 8-bit digital input. The maximum range is 8-bit. It only converts up to 8 bits of input data only. So the 8-bit digital data is converted as the current signal with help of our IC1408. We have another IC, that is SCRNE5018 integrating circuit. This is also an 8-bit digital to analog converter with output as the voltage. But this IC5018 will convert the 8-bit digital input into the voltage signal, analog voltage signal. But our 1408 convert the 8-bit digital input into the analog current signal. Here the output is current signal. Here the output is voltage signal. But the range of input data is always be within 8 bits only. Okay, this is only 8-bit chip. Okay, we have 16-bit chips, 32-bit chips, 64-bit chips also. But our IC1408 and IC5018 are the 8-bit digital to analog converters. Our IC1408 will produce the current signal as the output signal, and 5018 will produce the voltage signal as the output signal. In syllabus, we have only IC1408 digital to analog converter. So let me see the IC1408 is a compatible with TTL and CMOS inverter logics with settling time around 300 nanoseconds. The pin diagram or pin configuration of IC1408 as shown in this figure. The pin diagram of IC1408 having 16 pins. This is a 8-bit converter, but it having 16 pins, an 8-bit digital to analog converter internally consisting of 16 pins. Okay, those 16 pins are represented in this figure. Okay, if you see the pin 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. These are the input pins from pin 5 to pin 12. Those are the input pins, okay, which carry the digital input signal of 8-bit data. Okay, so A1, A2, A3, A4. A5, A6, A7, A8. Those are digital input pins. We are supplying the 8-pin digital input through the pins 5 to 12. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 4 pins, 8 pins. And the first pin is the output range control pin. To control the range of output, we can use this pin, first pin. And the second pin is the ground pin. Okay, the third pin and 13 pins are the supply pins. They will carry the supply of VEE and VCC. Positive VEE and negative VCC carry by the pins 3 and 13. And the remaining pins are 14, 15, 16. Okay. Sorry, 4 also. The 4th pin is the current output pin. And the 14th and 15th pins are the positive reference voltage and negative reference voltages. And 16th pin is the compensation pin. These are the 16 pins in our IC1408. The first pin is output range control pin. Second pin is the ground pin. Third pin is the VEE pin. Fourth pin is the current output pin. From 5th pin to 12th pin, 8 pins are the input pins. They will carry the digital input signal. Okay. 13th pin is the VCC pin. 14th pin and 15th pins are positive and negative reference voltages, and the last pin, 16th pin, is the compensation pin. Okay, let me see the pin connections of our IC1408. The pin connections is depending upon the type of IC. Okay, we can operate our IC1408 in two modes, which is maybe unipolar mode or bipolar mode. Okay, this is for unipolar range, this is for bipolar range. If you see the unipolar circuit, this 8 pins from pin 5 to 12 will carries the 8-bit digital input. So these 8 pins are used to carry the 8-bit digital input data. And pin 16 and 3 is short circuited with a capacitor of 15 picofarads, and pin 3 carries VEE voltage value. Okay, and pin 1, 2 also short circuited with the ground. Pin 15 will carry 2.5 kilo ohm of resistance through a ground potential. Okay, the 15th pin is grounded through a resistance of 2.5 kilo ohm. And the 4th pin will carry our operational amplifier as shown in this figure. The remaining pins are 13 and 14. 13 will carry the VCC supply, and 14 will carry a positive reference voltage of 5 volts with a 2.5 kilo ohm resistance. Okay, so this is the connecting diagram of our unipolar range type IC1408 digital to analog converter. If it is a bipolar, all the connections should be same, but we use an additional 5 kilo ohm resistance in between reference voltage to the non-inverting terminal. So we use an additional 5 kilo ohm resistance, which is connected to our reference voltage to the inverting terminal of the operational amplifier. Let me see the parameters, working parameters of our IC1408, whether it may be operated in unipolar mode or it can be operated in bipolar mode. Okay, so first we see the unipolar mode. The IC1408 is to be designed with a reference current. Actually, it can be designed with the reference current. The reference current is carried here. Okay, so the reference current value IR is generally 2 milliamperes. So how can we calculate the IR value? IR is the reference current carried by the pin 14. So the reference current is nothing but reference voltage divided by reference resistance. Reference voltage is 5 volts. Reference resistance is 2.5 kilo ohm. So the reference current IR is equal to VR divided by R14. And VR value is 5. R14 value is 2.5 kilo. Finally, we get 2 milliamperes. So the reference current in unipolar IC1408 is 2 milliamperes. Now, find the analog output current. We already said this carries the current signal as the output. Okay, so the current formula for output current formula, which is in analog form, the I0 is equal to IR into D1 by 2 power 1 plus D2 by 2 square plus D3 by 2 cube plus and so on. Last bit is D8 divided by 2 power 8. Okay. So the I0 is equal to, formula for IR is VR divided by R14. So I naught is equal to VR divided by R14 into, I am representing this series from 1 to 8 as sigma notation. Sigma I is equal to not 0, actually this is 1. Okay, I is equal to 1 to 8 DI divided by 2 power I. Okay, so the analog output voltage V naught is equal to, this is formula for current. Okay, and the analog output voltage V naught is equal to I naught into RF. So I am multiplying the above expression with RF, we get V naught. So V naught is equal to VR into RF divided by R14 into sigma I is equal to 1 to 8 DI divided by 2 power I. DI divided by 2 power I. For a digital input binary mode, D is equal to 0. Let us assume we are calculating the output voltage for a digital input of 0. Okay, all the bits having 0 magnitude. We get the output voltage V naught value as 0. Okay, if you calculate the full scale value for a digital input of 1111, all the bits, all the 8 bits having the maximum magnitude of 1, then we get V naught as V reference value as 5, RF value as 5 divided by R14 value is 2.5. If you substitute 1 magnitudes in this expression, then it will becomes 255 divided by 256. By substituting D1 place as 1, D2 as 1, D3 as 1, and so on, D8 as 1. By taking LCM, we get 255 divided by 256. And the magnitude value as output is equal to 9.96 volts. So for a full scale input, we get the output as 9.96 volts. For full scale input voltage, I naught value as, this is voltage value, and the I naught value as, I naught value, VR value as, VR divided by R14 value as 2 milliamperes into, if you substitute once in this place, we get 255 divided by 256. Finally, it is 1.99 milliamperes. Okay. So for full scale input value of data, we get current value as 1.99 milliamperes and voltage value as 9.96 volts. For zero input data, we get voltages and current values as zero. Okay. So this is for unipolar operation. If it can be operated as bipolar mode, we connect an additional RB resistance of 5 kilo ohm in between reference voltage to the non-inverting terminal. So for obtain bipolar output voltage, one resistance RB is connected between reference voltage and inverted terminal of the operational amplifier. Then we apply a KCL at mode A. At node A, if you apply KCL, then this current is equal to this current. Okay. So I naught is equal to IB plus I naught is equal to IB plus this small value of output current I naught dash. And I naught dash is equal to I naught minus IB. So the output voltage V naught is equal to this output current I naught dash into RF. And I naught dash value as I naught minus IB. So V naught is equal to I naught minus IB into RF. We already derived the formula for I naught in previous case. Okay, so I naught value is VR divided by R14 into sigma I is equal to 1 to 8 DI divided by 2 power I minus formula for IB is VR minus RB. Formula for IB is reference voltage divided by resistance. So VR divided by RB into RF. So calculate the voltage values for different input values. In case one, I am taking the digital input as 0, means all the 8 bits input datas are zeros. Then we get V naught as this entire expression becomes 0 minus VR value is 5 divided by RB value is 5. 5 divided by 5 is 1 into 5. Feedback resistance value. So it will becomes the output voltage is minus 5 volts when the input is 0. Okay. So in case 2, we can take the input as 100, 1000, and 4 zeros. 1000, 0000 as the input, the output as 0 because we get 1 here. In the place of this term, we get 1 here. 1 minus 1 is 0. So finally, we get the output voltage as 0 for the input data of this thing. Okay. Next, we calculate the full scale output voltage. For a full scale input voltage, input signal, that is D is equal to 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1, 4 ones, 4 ones. We get V naught as full scale current, we already find it, this thing, minus 1 milliampere into 5 kilo, we get 4.96 volts. So for full scale value, full scale input voltage, input value, we get the output voltage as 4.96 value. Okay, half of the value of previous case. Okay, so this is the concept of our IC1408 digital to analog converter. This will convert an 8-bit digital input data into an analog signal, which is discussed here with the corresponding pin diagrams and chip diagrams. Okay, so this is about the today class.